I'm Karl Kalonka, and this is my job, traveling across North America in search of the best crappie holes while hooking up with some legendary crappie fishermen and a host of colorful characters along the way, visiting some distinctive destinations and having opportunity to sample some very unique culinary cuisine.
The Xtreme Crappie Angler is presented by B&M Poles, leader in crappie, Crappie Magnet, Sore Lip 'em All, Power Pole, Shallow Water Anchor.
You know where we are? Cedar Lake. Where are we? Southernmost Illinois with these two characters right here, Buddy Chopper and Luke. One thing about crappie fishing, yeah, it's about catching big crappie. And down here in the States, they got sick big crappie, man. I mean, like 4-pound state records and stuff. But it's a camaraderie, having some fun, some laughs, and man, we all want to catch fish, so a little competition down here. It's early October, and we're down here with these guys, gonna have some fun on Cedar Lake. Gonna explain the whole deal, how they do it, where they do it, you name it, man. The only thing they're not gonna give up is waypoints, because that's up to you to figure it out. But me, him, and him, today, here, in this place called like Crappie Paradise, we're gonna have some fun with Luke and Chopper.
Right now we're set up on a brush pile right here in 20 foot of water. Bunch of crappie around, there's some shad around here, and they are feeding this morning. So we're gonna use these drop shots. We're just using a 1/2 ounce weight drop shot. We're gonna drop it down about 15 foot and see what happens.
So how long are these ones? 10 foot, 12 foot?
Yeah, these 11, these are 10.
Okay,
10
and 11 super sensitive foot, so. Too, eh?
Yeah.
And you got, I see you got braid here too, right?
Braided yeah. line, okay. Yeah, it helps a little bit with the feel, and right. then a fluorocarbon leader. Okay. The water's clear, so we can't go straight braid.
Right.
We can't get bit.
So there's no way you're not gonna miss that bite with the braid, right?
You'll feel it.
Yeah,
straight
you'll
down
feel
like
it.
That. Feel it.
Yeah.
All right, let's have some fun.
Every year we look forward to Karl coming down and fishing with us, and we fished in the spring, we fished in the fall, and this year, you know, this week happened to be 90 degrees, which it typically isn't in October. Last time we filmed, it was 40 degrees.
Is that cold enough for you? Is it? Because it's going to get even colder. And we're out here. Good thing we bundled up, otherwise we'd be back at the house. Jeez, eh?
So we're out here on Cedar Lake. It's my home lake, 10 minutes from my house. Karl wanted to come film a show, and it's one of my favorite lakes to fish. Typically this time of year, the water temperature is down 65, 70 degrees. Currently it's 80 degrees. The stuff that I usually fish this time of year, 15 foot of water, is just not producing. All the bait fish is deep. So I had to go find some deeper water, 20 to 25 foot water, which is not what I typically fish, but we made it work.
Chopper, if we caught one or two on every brush pile out here, how many fish would we have?
Uh-oh. At least 300.
Uh-oh, we're getting there. We're getting there slowly. 300!
At least.
I think we could do a show, folks, of 300 crappie. Now, I'm not bragging, but I think that's the second biggest one of the day so far. I think the show's done. I always love the color of these whites. We don't have whites at home.
Yeah, they've got a lot of color right now.
Yeah,
because the water is so clear.
It's you think so it's because of the brush, too? Look at that.
Probably.
A 3-pounder would never get hooked like that.
No.
I couldn't have bought a better bite right there. Look how pretty they are, man. They got blue and all kinds of stuff, eh? I just want to see one that's about another 10 inches.
Yeah,
huh?
That's what we're looking for.
Oh, a little crappie. All right, back to Cedar Lake with Chopper and Luke, and a little bit different this time. Last time I was here was in October, and I had to borrow clothes from Luke. I mean, like big pants, jackets and hats and gloves and all kinds of stuff. So you never know what Mother Nature is gonna throw at you. Extreme cold and wind or extreme heat, and this time it's the heat.
Good fish,
oh,
too.
Yeah. He said he,
you got it?
He said he's in the zone. He said he's in that zone.
White crappie.
On a slow day, you'd keep those ones, eh?
He's been eating. Yeah, he's not a great fish. You want to eat him?
Fill it up.
Someone will.
Middle man.
Yeah, I'm just going to sit down. I'll eat snacks and... let you guys catch them.
What we were doing today was we were drop shotting. Basically, we were taking a 1/2 ounce weight
and about a foot, foot and a half up, we would just use a little bitty gold hook and had to tip it with a minnow.
That's a good one. Better fish.
Yep.
Better fish right there.
That's one of the ones right there. Yep. Sorry, Luke, I got my line tied up.
He's got it.
All right.
Fine job.
Good stuff, Luke. Me and Chopper were busy.
I was busy fishing.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, don't help me. I'll give you guys all the minnows you want.
Can you give me a minnow when you're done?
I'll
need a minnow too.
Yep.
Into the capture cage. Mm-hmm. Everybody need a minnow?
No, I just got
to. I'm good.
Talk about hot. Think about it, man. You know, I'm wearing this little neck thing to help me block the sun, but man, I am soaking it to keep myself down, these temperatures and stuff. And they said it's gonna be in the 90s, Carl, with sun. It's never in the 90s in the sun in October, and it is. And the crappie are biting, but man, oh man, it is a little bit of effort. No complaining, but this is effort. Deep crappie. You know, Luke and Chopper are saying both that Cedar Lake just cleared up for some reason and stuff like that. And you know those crappie love to hide structure, you know, brush piles and different things. So we definitely have to fish deeper. But when Chopper told me we're gonna be in like in 22, 23, 25 feet of water, that's deep for this lake.
Come on, crappie. There's
a good one. Oh, there's a good one. Yeah. That's a good one.
Atta boy, Chopper. Atta boy, Chopper.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's a good one.
That's a white still?
There's a good one.
Yeah, it's a white.
Oh, yeah.
That one's going on ice, isn't it?
Look at that one.
Yeah. Look at that crappie, man. Look how thick their back is, too.
Wow. Healthy.
Now, isn't that a black?
This is a black.
Yeah, it is black. Wow, black. Man.
It's got the yellow.
Yep.
Doesn't have the vertical.
Look at the hump on his head, man.
Beauty.
Man, he scrapped pretty good, too, eh?
Yeah.
Atta boy, Chopper.
Put him in there.
Before anybody else sees, quick.
Yeah, hide him. Hide him.
My buddy Chopper come out here for several days and practice and told me it was going to be tough, but we managed to catch some really good crappie today. As tough as it was and as hot as it was.
There's one. Feels pretty good, too.
Yeah, good.
Oh, yeah. Hey, look at that thing. Wow. Please, net. Please, net. Thank you, sir. Just when you said it, I brought it off that stuff, eh, Chopper?
Yeah.
Wow. It's a white one, too, huh?
White. Big, fat white.
Come here. Stop. 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 Nice, soup. Wow, nice. My first keeper on cedar. Again, man, when it goes through that top lip, it's never coming off. I didn't need that. I could have fought him for like 10 minutes. Oh, yeah, man. That is the deal.
He's got a lot of color, too.
Yeah, man. Just that big black spot I would love seeing, eh? Boy, it's those backs with all that meat, huh? Well, in the cooler, catching some crappie. So Chopper, you're thinking for sure that, because you caught these fish or found these fish when it was sunny, right?
Yes.
And they're right tight to the
brush. Yeah, I'm seeing a lot of roaming fish. I think later in the day, this bite will definitely pick up.
So they might be roaming around on the outside of this right now.
I think they're just off of it feeding on shad. That's,
yeah.
They can get away with a whole lot more when it's low light conditions. They don't have to hide as well.
The bite was difficult. Typically it's a good jig bite, they thump it, but we had to downsize to a drop shot rig, which is still fun fishing, but it's just a little bit more technical, a little bit more difficult to feel the bite, but it's what we had to do to make the show.
Good fish.
Decent nice one fish. There, yeah.
Good. Oh yeah, atta boy. Boy, Chubber. Yeah, that's an eater.
I didn't even feel him bite. He just down there laying on it.
Wow.
Can I have a minnow, please?
Yeah, sure. Minnow man.
Somebody's gotta do it.
Yeah.
And we're still catching fish. That's all that matters, you know? Whether they be 18 feet to 22 feet, we're still catching them. But a lot of times, it's that first drop. it's the big alpha male or female who's on that brush pile who's eating our baits.
Another one. Uh-oh.
Huh?
Yeah.
Net? Yeah, it looks like it.
Oh.
Oh, that's why, eh?
Wild man.
Oh, nice fish, though.
A Zorro cat. Now, you know how to keep those like that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I just had to ask. I thought you had a 3-pounder there.
I did, too. I didn't know what I had going on.
Springtime in the Shawnee means trees and wildflowers bursting with color and birdsong that fills the air. Discover towering cliffs and cascading waterfalls. Wander forest trails that wind between ancient rock formations. From the banks of the Ohio to the edge of the mighty Mississippi, the Shawnee National Forest is home to diverse wildlife and untold natural wonders just waiting for you to explore. Embark on your own adventure or take a guided tour. When you can walk among giants and climb a little closer to the sun, that's how you'll know you're in Shawnee Forest Country.
No trip to Southernmost Illinois would be complete without a visit to the world-famous 17th Street Barbecue in Murfreesboro.
I'm Sayla, I'm from 17th Street, and I'm gonna show you guys how we make our baked beans today. So in here we have our brown sugar. I'm gonna add ketchup, and we add mustard, and our secret blend of baked bean seasoning, which I can't give away the secret on how it's made. But that's our secret ingredient, is our seasoning. And I'm just gonna stir this up. I wanna get all the chunks of the brown sugar out as best that I can. Then I'm gonna start, I have my pork and beans. Dump all that in. And I have chili beans. Pour those in. And again, I'm gonna stir. Make sure I get all the way to the bottom, make sure I get all that good ketchup and sugar. And this makes a really large batch. This is about, it'll make about 5 gallons of beans, but it's one of our most popular dishes, so we make a lot of beans around here. Okay, and then I have kidney beans, which I've already drained and rinsed. I'm gonna pour those in. These are our dark red kidney beans. And we get large butter beans, which are drained and rinsed as well. Stir those in. And I have 2 more ingredients I have to go in the walk-in and get. I'm gonna add some peppers and onions.
I'm Philip Hearn, the pit master at 17th Street Bar and Grill, and we're going to prep some baby back ribs. We use a 2-pound loin back rib, custom cut for us. So they're nice and square. That way if you get 3 bones or a hat rack, it all looks the same. We're also very consistent in the product, so they all, if we cook hundreds of racks a day, that means they'll all be consistent. We get the rib in pre-peeled. Usually there's a skin on the back. We pay a little extra to get them peeled. And we would remove the membrane if we weren't peeling them. If we had to peel them, we would remove the membrane. But we're just gonna go back and clean up anything on the back. There could be a little bit of membrane left they missed. Any extra fat. If there's anything that's hanging off the rib that doesn't look good, you don't want to eat it, we'll cut it off. Any extra fat on the top, this one looks good. And of course we're gonna put our dry rub, our magic dust, on there. We're gonna do a light coat, real even, down both sides on the back, and on the top, and then we'll give them 2 more coats during the cooking process.
Hi, I'm Mike Mills. Life is too short for a half rack.
The drop shot rig that we use today is a 1/2 ounce weight that we actually pour. It's made for spider rigging. But it slides right through the brush. Easy, and just a number 4 Aberdeen gold hook. In case you do hang it in the brush, it's easy to bend out. You don't have to break off and retie. And just a simple minnow.
You got something going on there.
Decent one.
Oh boy. Yeah, man. Look at that. Yeah, man.
That's a good one.
All right.
You just finished saying someone's in the sweet spot.
It was.
Hey. Good fish.
Oh yeah, man. Hold them up for a second. You can see it there.
About half the bites were real hard and other bites were very subtle. And sometimes, I mean, that's just crappie fishing, and that's how it is. You've got to figure it out each day.
You know, it doesn't matter where I fish for crappie. Anywhere in the States and Ontario and stuff, it's just, it doesn't matter. White crappie, black crappie, it's something about the feeling that little boop, that little thump. That's all it is. Whether it be 9 feet down, 20 feet down, it doesn't matter. Holding that B&M pole, shaking it a bit, holding it, and all of a sudden, there's life. Boop. And everything just goes quiet. It's just you and the crappie. You know, Mother Nature made crappie as the perfect fish. The bigger they get, the easier they are to come off. That's just the way it goes. That membrane around their mouth, the bigger they can get and elude anglers all their life, there's a better chance that they're gonna come off. The thrill is chasing them down, hunting them down, get them to bite, but man, you have to have that net on those fish fast.
Yeah, it's dandy.
Uh-oh, this is stuck. Oh, let's see, where are you? Oh, you're just gonna lift him in? Come on.
There you got him.
Hey, I told you, you're gonna get him, Luke.
Little theater.
Yeah, just the net was stuck and I was one-handed and didn't let my rod go either, in case I got bit. Atta boy, Luke, another black, huh?
Another black.
Black crappie. Show them boys. This is how he does it right there.
Crappie Master Luke.
Yeah. Cool Hand Crappie Luke.
That's correct.
That's your new name?
Cool Hand Crappie.
Yeah.
Hey, don't worry about it, guys. I'll get my own minnow.
Starting off in the morning, we had to drop it all the way down to the bottom and just hold the bait right there. And then the crappie would bite it. As the sun got higher and the crappie got tighter to the brush piles, what we would do is we'd drop it to the bottom and then we'd pull it up very slowly and then drop it right back down. And that's when they bit.
I'll just tell you when I get close to the brush. Come on, fish. Really? Oh. No, he's a swinger, right? Wow. I almost said again, brush. See, so that last one I had, it was a fish. It was a fish. Stop it. Though. Stop it. You want to make my shirt messy? Okay. Whoa, easy now. Easy now. Wow, they're tough little guys, aren't they? Tough little guys. Look at that. An eater. I got an eater. Come on, boy. Yep. But he must have been right in the brush, because at first I couldn't move it, and then I pulled him out.
But you got to change with the fish. You got to let the fish tell you how they want the bait. And that's a key to crappie fishing, is every day, every hour, it's changing. So you just gotta roll with it, and once you figure it out, then you can start catching them.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's a good fish.
Need the net?
Another one. Look!
Look at that.
Look at that, dudes! This one I meant, not the one in the net. I can still catch, folks!
Look at that.
Think about that, eh? Look at that. In the edit room, I'll change that around.
Switch hands.
That's a mirror image.
Mirror image.
Very nice. Way to go, Luke. Yeah, they're awesome. They almost look like saltwater fish, don't they? Crappie. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they've got a lot of color.
Iridescence. So now we know they're suspended.
They are suspended. So we use the drop shot rig, which is a simple 1/2 ounce weight. We typically use this for spider rigging. It's got an eye on both ends, but we just use the top eye. Tie that to the bottom of your line. Tie a loop knot off of your fluorocarbon. We're using braid, 25 pound braid, with a 10 pound fluorocarbon leader. The water is super clear and the fish can see the line, so we have to put that leader on. And when we're drop shotting, it's not a jig bite, so it's a real light bite most of the time. Some of them will knock it pretty good,
But we're using B&M 11-foot super sensitive rods, which you can actually feel your minnow swimming around. So the lightest bite you can definitely feel with the B&M super sensitives. It's my favorite drop shot rod when they're not thumping the jig. There, he got him.
Yep.
Good one, too.
Oh, it's a good one. Yep. Oh, yes. He was walking with it, chopper.
Was he?
Yeah. Whoa, look at that. I was lifting up, and I seen the line just going like this with it. I
just,
go,
just swim with it.
He's a white, too, isn't he?
Yeah, he's a white.
Eating white. That's the key part right there, isn't it? That's
thick
it right
back.
There. Hot afternoon crappies, boys. Whoo! We are burning the midnight oil in the middle of the day. Look at it, flat calm. I fished you guys before here and we were wearing snowsuits almost, eh?
Yeah, same time of year.
And now it's 90. So you prove you can catch them in any weather here, huh? Cedar Lake, man.
Cedar Lake.
Another fantastic experience here in Illinois. And a big thank you to the Southernmost Illinois Tourism Bureau, you know, the people here at Cedar Lake, and all the amenities and stuff. We had fantastic barbecue, 17th Street barbecue and stuff like that. And you talk about road trips to come down here to Illinois. Think about the weather. We're fishing in shorts, 90 degrees, catching crappie, good food, fantastic Southern hospitality. Hey, it's here waiting for you. Come on down.
The Xtreme Crappie Angler was presented by B&M Poles, the leader in crappie, Power Pole, Shallow Water Anchor, Crappie Magnet, Sore Lip 'Em All. Visit us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.